landing from over the pole, flying in a big airliner, chicken flying everywhere around the plane. Could we ever feel much finer? Coming into Los Angeles, bringing in a couple of keys. Don't touch my bags if you please, Mr. Customs Man. No, we couldn't look much stranger. Walking in a hall with his things and all. Smiling said he was the Lone Ranger. Coming into Los Angeles. Bringing in a couple of keys. Don't touch my bags if you please, Mr. Customs Man.
Now, a great deal of time, sweat, and a few tears were expended on all this, but there's a lot of satisfaction in developing ideas into realities which become a part of Disneyland.
And welcome to another episode of Theme Park World Tour. We've come all the way to Disneyland here in California. Disneyland is perhaps still the epitome of modern day storytelling. When you walk onto Main Street, you step back to America at the turn of the century, where the gaslight is giving way to electricity, and horse-drawn streetcars are giving way to the gasoline engine. It was the only Disney park that Walt Disney himself ever actually set foot in. In fact, Walt ended up living at the park most of the time, taking an apartment above the fire station. Everyone would know when Walt was home, as he would light the lamp in the apartment window. Nowadays, in tribute, the lamp is left on all of the time, so Walt is always here. I wonder what he would think of the progress being made with the Disney brand across the whole world. Before exploring more of Disneyland, we actually hopped back across the road to Sister Park, California Adventure. Our first stop, the town of Radiator Springs.
The only one seeing this, right?
Well, if you ever plan to motor west, Jack, take my way, it's the highway, that's the best. Get your kicks on Route 66. Well, it winds from Chicago to L.A., more than 2,000
Winona, Kingsman, Bar, Scott, San Bernardino. Won't you get hip to this kindly tip and take that California trip? Get your kicks on Route 66.
A really cool little fun fact about the cars ride, which I'm now going to show you. So there's going to be some cars coming around now, any minute. So inside a trade secret that I'm just about to reveal to you all, the cars are actually silent in all the planter beds just down here to my left. I don't know exactly where, but they're hidden speakers. Pretty cool.
Hollywood, California. The movie capital of the world. And when you want to hobnob with the stars, there's only one place to stay. The Hollywood Tower Hotel. Until that tragic night in 1939, when five people checked in, never to be seen again.
Welcome to the Hollywood Tower Hotel, where the elevator...
I'll take you to 13.
...shoots you straight up. And when the doors open, you're in for the elevator ride of your life. Enter a new dimension of fear.
Hollywood Tower Hotel.
The Twilight Zone Tower of Terror. A 13-story plummet, faster than gravity itself. Straight down through the historically haunted Hollywood Tower Hotel. The Twilight Zone Tower of Terror at the Disneyland Resort May 5th.
You can't miss it.
Drop in if you dare.
Although I never got to experience the original Tower of Terror, this was another ride that I dreamt about going on.
Where are you going, Main Street?
Blah, blah, blah.
Hey, the name's Rocket, and I need your help. The Collector has trapped my friends, the Guardians of the Galaxy, in his weird freak show. Check it out. This is the joint we're in, and we need you to help us break out. Got it? Good. Now move it. I gotta go.
Parents, it is now time. Row 3, top right. And row 4, you will go to the top left. Row 2, follow them through. You will be in the middle on the right-hand side. Row 5, follow them. You will be middle left.
I didn't know how this machine worked. What a bunch of a-holes.
Smoking hot Rayjack girl? Stabbed me with a fork. Didn't like me skipping out on her sunrise.
I like your knife. I'm keeping it.
This is the moment you have been waiting for.
Outfit, man. Ninja Turtle, you better stop poking me.
Gurit.
Gurit. Look, I'm gonna be totally honest with you. I forgot you're here.
Boys of mine wanted to eat you.
Yeah?
They ain't never tasted any Terran before. I stopped them. You're alive causing me.
Should have learned.
I don't learn. One of my issues.
So we just got off Guardians of the Galaxy, which used to be Tower of Terror here at Disneyland Resort. I can't wipe the smile off my face. It was absolutely fantastic. A lot more forceful than I was expecting.
Whatever you think about the re-theming of this ride, I don't think many theme park enthusiasts would argue that the thoughts and ideals that Walt Disney seemed to have back at the start, that there is no more powerful setting than a theme park than which to tell a story.
Or you got a friend in me. got a friend in me. You got a friend in me. You got trouble, and I got them too. There isn't anything what you do for you. We stick together, see it through, 'cause you got a friend in me. You got a friend in me. Some other folks might be a little bit smarter than I am. Big and strong too. Me and you, boy, and as the years go by, a friendship will never die. You're gonna see it's our destiny. You got a friend in me. You got a friend in me. You got a friend in me.
Around to get his attention, and then
we'll go. Here is your home. Ariel, listen to me. The human world, it's a mess. Life under the sea is better than anything they got up there. The seaweed is always greener in somebody else's lake. You dream about going up there, but that is a big mistake. Under the sea, under the sea. Darling, it's better down where it's wetter. Take it from me. Up on the shore, they work all day. Out in the sun, they slave away. While they're devoting full time, you're floating under the sea. Down here, all the fish is happy as off through the waves they roll. The fish on the land ain't happy. It's hard 'cause they in the bowl. But fish in the bowl is lucky. They in for a worse fate. One day when the boss get hungry.
Yes, you got me on the plate.
But no, under the sea. Under the sea. Nobody beat us, fry us, and eat us in fricassee. We want the land folks loves to cook. Under the sea, we have to hook up. We got no trouble. Life is the bubbles under the sea.
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 Since life is media, we got to be here naturally.
Naturally,
even the sturgeon and the ray, they get the air to start to play. We got to hear it, you got to hear it, under the sea. Each little clown here know how to drown here under the sea. Each little slug here cutting a rug here under the sea. Each little snail here know how to wail here. That's why it's hotter under the water. Yeah, we in luck here down in the muck here under the sea.
It was nearly time to fly back over to Disneyland, but first, we had a ride on Soaring. Something the current Imagineers of Disneyland know only too well is the art of storytelling. And it's something that's at the heart of the new attractions to be found in Galaxy's Edge.
Today, I am proud to announce the Walt Disney Company is acquiring Lucasfilm, the global entertainment company founded by George Lucas and the home of the legendary Star Wars franchise.
On October the 30th, 2012, when George Lucas sold the Star Wars franchise to Disney, suddenly a lifelong dream of Star Wars fans was able to become a reality.
Fans can expect a new feature film, as well as consumer products, television projects, games, and theme park attractions. And theme park attractions. And theme park attractions.
Okay, so we've come to Disneyland basically so I can go and see Galaxy's Edge. And I'm rather excited. Here we go.
And Galaxy's Edge was to be the first chance to walk right into the world of Star Wars.
Pretty much the coolest thing about Galaxy's Edge is you can actually come and fly the Millennium Falcon.
Should I have?
This is... Hello, hello, my friends! I am Hondo Onaka, and this is Onaka Transport Solutions. Today, I am offering the opportunity of a lifetime. I need flight crews to transport this valuable merchandise across the galaxy. Pilots to navigate, engineers to operate the ship, and gunners to defend the shipments. And that is where you come in.
Flight takes you to the planet Corellia. You will be intercepting a first order train shipment of coaxium. Gunners, you clear the path. Pilots, line up behind the train. And engineers, you harpoon that precious cargo. And as we always say here at Onaka Transport Solutions, get out of here and go make Hondo some money.
Everybody take your seats, sit down, buckle up.
For your safety, remain seated and supervise younglings. For example, burn the next time. I was just about to say that. Pilot on the right, pull back on the stick to fly up, and push forward to fly down. Weapons are online.
Chewie, we're home.
Hit the boosters. Now let's go get that coaxium. Right pilot, make the jump to light speed.
Han Solo, I'm Captain of the Millennium Falcon.
It's the ship that made the Kessel Run in less than 12 parsecs.
The cave is collapsing!
This is no cave!
What?
Ship, well, I grab the gold axiom! You see, just as I promised, my friend. Come on, let's get another container of coaxium! Pilots! Line up behind the train so we can harpoon that last car. Flight engineers, fire the harpoons and reel us in. Now let's shoot the train. Oh, so close. Keep reeling. The cargo is breaking free. Keep shooting. Good job, my friends. Yes, yes, yes. We got the coaxium. I will grab it. You keep up to the train.
Where are you going? Come back!
Certainly has courage.
What good will it do us if he gets himself killed?
But they're gonna kill her!
Better her than me.
Yes, a distraction! Fire the missiles at the train! Hurry!
I don't know who you are or where you came from. From now on, you do as I tell you, okay?
Yes, pilot, hit the boosters! Boost! 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 We made it! I don't believe it, but we made it! Now, let's get out of here!
Look, your worshipfulness, let's get one thing straight. I take orders from just one person, me.
So wonder you're still alive.
We'll retrieve two containers of coaxium. This will greatly help the resistance. You have heard the first order and made Chewie proud. Now after my modest profit, your cut minus what you owe me for damaging the Falcon is, hey, not bad.
What do you think? You think a princess and a guy like me?
No.
Look, I ain't in this for your revolution, man. I'm not in it for you, princess. I expect to be well paid. I'm in it for the money.
Hokey religions and ancient weapons are no match for a good blaster at your side, kid.
I thought that myself. Thought it was a bunch of mumbo jumbo. A magical power holding together good and evil, the dark side and the light.
Kid, I've flown from one side of this galaxy to the other. I've seen a lot of strange stuff, but I've never seen anything to make me believe there's one all-powerful force controlling everything. There's no mystical energy field that controls my destiny.
Crazy thing is, it's true. All of it. The Force, the Jedi, it's all true.
as well as the Millennium Falcon, Smuggler's Run, visitors to Galaxy's Edge can fully explore Black Spire Outpost. The outpost features various food stalls and shops. You can buy blue and green milk. Of course, you can even build your own lightsaber.
Alright. Here we go, get ready. We're hacking in.
Sometimes I amaze even myself.
That doesn't sound too hard.
And some of the guys have been playing around with the app. You can get some of the droids to talk to you, get panels to light up on some of the walls here around Black Spire Outpost. It's really cool. So if you do come to Galaxy's Edge, make sure you do download the Disneyland app.
What I loved about Galaxy's Edge is how the whole area could easily change and develop further. In early 2020, a new attraction, Rise of the Resistance, is going to open.
I think any great story has tension and conflict, and it's not Star Wars without the war. So it was absolutely fundamental that the story of the land actually finds the guest between the Resistance and the First Order.
One of the experiences that I'm sure every visitor to Star Wars Galaxy's Edge is gonna love is the most epic attraction we've ever built, Star Wars Rise of the Resistance. This attraction invites you to be a recruit of the Resistance, to stand up against the First Order, and you even come face to face with Kylo Ren. You make it through that, you get back to the planet, you are going to be a hero of the Resistance and celebrated throughout the land.
It's exciting to think about this as only the beginning and to think about how this land will be living and breathing and evolving. There is nothing actually more meaningful and more special than to provide a place for people to experience Star Wars with their family for decades to come.
Join me, and together we can rule the galaxy as father and son.
We left Galaxy's Edge, and I thought to myself that Walt would have probably been pleased with the new land. It was nearly time to leave, but there was still time for some fireworks and a chance to ride Hyperspace Mountain.
Rebel base in range.
You may fire when ready.
Commence primary ignition.
Absolutely incredible day. I've flown the Millennium Falcon, I've met Chewbacca, I've drunk blue milk. I'm not sure what else a Star Wars fan could possibly want. Rise of the Resistance will open in the new year, and the word is it's going to be a fantastic, fantastic attraction. That's it here from Galaxy's Edge in California. Thank you for watching. If you've enjoyed what you've seen, please don't forget to subscribe and turn your notifications on.
Dark desert highway, the cool wind in my hair, the warm smell of colitas rising up through the air. Up ahead in the distance, I saw a shimmering light. My head grew heavy and my sight grew dim. I had to stop for the night. she stood in the doorway. I heard the mission bell, and I was thinking to myself, this could be heaven or this could be hell. And then she lit up a candle, and then she showed me the way. There were voices down the corridor. I thought I heard them say, welcome to the Hotel California. It's such a lovely place. It's such a lovely face.